What's up, guys? My name is today, and today we are going to be talking about fractures, bone breakages, and what to do with the bone anatomy, bone structural anatomy of the human body if you have these injuries, which most people think that you're going to stay on your ass and you can't do anything. Like, let's say if I had I can't do anything. That's not true. I do many core, obliques, rectus abdominis, transverse abdominis, and actual positioning, training, from which, again, you balance, you focus on flexibility, mobility, stability, which is crucial for your posture, and making sure that you don't have an anatomically induced posture, which is a standard posture. Again, it has no benefit to it. It has no real reasoning to it. It has no real description except for it's a standard posture that most humans take. And this is why their thoracic vertebrae, lumbar vertebrae, and sciatic nerve is going to be dealing with the most pain, the most stress on that instead of the muscles that are actually supposed to increase the stability, and that are supposed to actually hold all of this pressure, because they can, and you're not causing your back to actually decrease in strength in practicing these exercises and just sitting, which is really bad because you're not doing anything, putting a lot of stress on your lower back when you literally sit down and you aren't doing anything except for playing. You think you're doing something, especially when you stand upright with your face up like that, sitting on your back face up. This is really bad, including when you're sitting up with your back stretched out. You're sitting like that. And again, how is this bad to stand like this? So if I would stand like this, then what am I doing? Well, I'm not really engaging in the upper back. I'm not involving the teres major, teres minor, and I'm not doing anything with the thoracic vertebrae. And many times, many studies have found that the lower back is, again, really weak. And if you just keep on sitting like this, anterior pelvic tilt, your pelvis is going to really, really, really get down to a state of not even developing. And basically, your hips are going to be getting injured a lot, and the rest of the anatomy is going to be affected by the one thing, which is sitting, laying down, not doing anything. But what should you do if you actually have some sort of sprain? Well, first of all, you should actually wait. First day, you should eat right, of course, because if you're not going to be exercising, you're going to gain a lot of weight, a lot of water weight, which means that you're not burning the calories that your body needs to get into a hypercaloric state to actually gain hypertrophy, to gain in muscle, and to actually work these muscles to feed them correctly. So again, you're going to be adding a lot of fat if you just decide to lay on your ass and not do anything for that matter. And I remember when I still had sprained wrist, I recently thought that it broke, came back, that no abnormalities were actually caused. They were not present. Which, again, that was pretty weird, because, again, I can do minimal stuff for them. I can't even do optimal training. I can't do my best type of training of that. Not even my best workout programs. I can't select them. because of my muscle restrictions. And this is going to affect muscle imbalances. So if you decide to just do one thing, one type, one half of the body. So I'm going to compare this to resting something and contracting another. So if you're retracting the other, you're contracting the one that you're putting the most stress on. The one is isometric, so that means it's developed without muscle contraction. And it has a high amount of tension but no muscle contraction. And the one is just going to be retracted, and it's just going to be resting. So if you rest, actually, performance is going to really, really decrease because you're focusing on that one muscle. You're not doing the other. Your core is going to not benefit. You're not going to carve out those abs that you want. You're not going to tone muscle. You're not going to gain in vascularity because you want. You're going to have a really bad posture in your back. Your pelvic tilt with scoliosis, a 20-degree back, which is going to have a curvature to it. So it's going to curve this way, right, instead of left. And we want to focus on it going up way instead of it going back or right or left. And kyphosis, which is a 45-degree angle in the back, which is a hunchback, and it makes it really hard to actually focus on targeting the back muscles. Your teres major, teres minor, going to decrease the amount of probability of you actually strengthening your thoracic vertebrae and actually helping your levator scapulae going along with your thoracic spine, and it's going to stop compression with it, which can be major because there's two types of compression. The bad one, one that's strenuous, brings a lot of strain, but the one that's actually contracting your traps and deltoids when you're going that way. And guys, that's the end of the video today, and this is the truth about bone breakages or bone fractures or sprain. I just wanted to get this out. The last thing I'm going to talk about is malunion, which is a healed fracture, and this term is again critical. Two of the terms that are critical are a delayed union and non-union. Non-union is when you have an inadequate amount of blood supply and stability to actually heal a fracture or a sprain. And delayed union is when you have the adequate amount of blood supply and stability to actually heal the fracture, sprain, or breakage. Guys, it's been good talking with you. I'll put up another set of videos in a couple of days, and see you guys when I finish up.